Hi everyone, my name is Vangelis and I will present your work, Slow-Fast Auditory Streams for Audio Recognition, which is a collaboration between myself, Arsana Grani, Andrew Zisserman, and Dima Damon. We're interested in audio recognition for actions and events, and we're exploring two datasets, EPIC-KITCHENS and VGG-Sound. These datasets have visually grounded sounds, and I will start with showcasing the characteristics of audio in these datasets, as well as our motivation through some video examples. Note that our work only uses audio, and video is displayed for demonstration purposes only. The audio signal in EPIC-KITCHENS is strong due to hand-object interactions. And also, because of the proximity of the microphone to the ongoing action, as participants are using wearable cameras. The main motivation of our work is that there are two types of sounds in these datasets. Harmonic sounds, defined as frequency-related sounds spanning in time, and percussive sounds, defined as momentary or temporally repetitive sounds. Similarly, in VGG sound, there are harmonic sounds possibly related to scenes, and animals, and percussive sounds. Based on these audio characteristics, we propose a two-stream architecture for audio recognition. We draw further inspiration from neuroscience, where there is strong evidence about the existence of dorsal and ventral streams in the human auditory system, where some work suggests that ventral has high spectral resolution, while dorsal has high temporal resolution and operates at a higher sampling rate. The architecture is inspired by slow-fast networks for video recognition. We propose slow and fast streams for audio recognition. Both streams take as input 2 seconds of audio converted into a spectrogram. Slow takes as input a subsample version of the spectrogram. The first layers perform only frequency convolutions, and there are convolutions in both frequency and time only at the end of the stream. Therefore, slow has low temporal precision as well as a large amount of channels to focus on learning frequency patterns. Fast, on the other hand, takes as input the full spectrogram and performs convolutions over both frequency and time throughout the whole stream. It has a high temporal resolution and fewer channels than slow to focus on modeling time. The two streams are fused with multi-level lateral connections from the fast to the slow stream with strided temporal convolutions and concatenation in the slow stream. We utilize separable convolutions to attend on frequency and time independently. Finally, both streams perform global average pooling and their representations are concatenated and fed to the prediction layer. We first present our results in VGG sound. We compare with ResNet 50 from the VGG sound paper, as well as another two-stream architecture, and we outperform both. The architecture in this paper splits the spectrogram in a high and a low frequency spectrogram and passes them to a high frequency processing and a low frequency processing stream. The large gap in performance shows that our proposal of having two streams that one specializes in time and the other in frequencies is better. Also note the large gap in performance between individual streams and our proposed slow-fast, conveying the large amount of complementary information between the proposed streams. For EPIC-KITCHENS, all models are initialized from the VGG sound models, as VGG sound is a large-scale dataset with a big variety of classes. Actions in EPIC-KITCHENS are formed from verbs and nouns, and we model this as multitask learning with 2 prediction heads. We outperform the previous state of the art, which is a single-stream GoogleNet architecture. You can look at our paper for ablations of individual streams and fusion approach, as well as for more evaluation metrics. Looking at the class-wise performance of both streams, we make some interesting observations. We show classes for which each stream is significantly better than the other. Slow outperforms fast for classes with animals such as horse neighing and cat hissing, as well as scenes such as sea waves. This verifies our assumption that slow focuses on frequencies, as different animals and scenes have very different frequencies. Fast is better at percussive sounds such as woodpecker pecking tree and chopping wood, showcasing that it focuses on modeling time. We finally demonstrate some qualitative results by playing the audio and showing each stream's predictions. There are easy cases where all streams make correct predictions. In other examples, only our proposed model makes the correct prediction, but one of the streams makes reasonable predictions as well, slow in this case. In some examples, only slow predicts both the verb and the noun correctly. And in others, only fast makes the correct prediction. We also show some qualitative results for VGG sound. Here, although only slow fast predicts the class correctly, fast is distracted by the calf at the end. Slow can predict the long-term sound of the sliding door, while both fast and slow fast are distracted from the clicking sounds, possibly due to the temporal detection capabilities of fast.
It'll go. Closing it, still get that repeated clicking, pounding.
And an example where possibly the localization capability of fast helps, as it might be able to isolate the sound of the wood hitting in the ground at the end. That was the end of my talk. Thank you very much for your attention. You can look at our webpage or download the code and models from the links or by scanning the QR codes.